Hello, folks. In this lesson, we are going to talk about the student's t-distribution and its characteristics. Before we begin, we use the lowercase letter t to define a student's t-distribution, followed by a single parameter, in parenthesis, called degrees of freedom. We read this next statement as, variable y follows a student's t-distribution with 3 degrees of freedom. As we mentioned in the last video, it is a small sample size approximation of a normal distribution. In instances where we would assume a normal distribution were it not for the limited number of observations, we use the student's t-distribution. For instance, the average lap times for the entire season of a Formula One race follow a normal distribution, but the lap times for the first lap of the Monaco Grand Prix would follow a student's t-distribution. Now, the curve of the student's t-distribution is also bell-shaped and symmetric. However, it has fatter tails to accommodate the occurrence of values far away from the mean. That is because if such a value features in our limited data, it would be representing a bigger part of the total. Another key difference between the student's t-distribution and the normal one is that apart from the mean and variance, we must also define the degrees of freedom for the distribution. Great job! As long as we have at least 2 degrees of freedom, the expected value of a t-distribution is the mean, mu. Furthermore, the variance of the distribution equals the variance of the sample times the number of degrees of freedom over degrees of freedom minus 2. Overall, the student's t-distribution is frequently used when conducting statistical analysis. It plays a major role when we want to do hypothesis testing with limited data, since we also have a table summarizing the most important values of its CDF. Great! Another distribution that is commonly used in statistical analysis is the chi-squared distribution. In the next video, we will explore when we use it and what other distributions it is related to. Thanks for watching.
If you found this video interesting and want to gain an edge in your career, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to check out some of our other videos for another quick win in the data science skills department.